MSF launched its HIV/AIDS treatment project in Malawi in 2001. 13 years on, MSF and the Ministry of Health now treat over 35,000 patients in the Chiradzulu district. In order to deliver quality care in a country severely affected by the pandemic and with a shortage of medical personnel, the teams initiated a process to decentralize treatment from district hospitals to health centers. Simplifying procedures, transferring skills within medical teams, and reducing the frequency of consultations for stable patients were the first steps.
A lot of fears that people had as far as ARV dispensation and HIV management is concerned, MSF has proved that this can be really handled by the least medically trained people. And ARVs and HIV is not that exceptional. MSF has shown that and has shown the world that task shifting is possible. Now in Chiradzulu, nurses can initiate patients on ARVs. They are able to follow up patients. Even these patients who never in their life see the COs, they continue to be seen by the nurses.
Recent innovations have resulted in several laboratory tests now being available at health centers. This is the case of the viral load test, for example, that identifies patients whose treatment is failing. These tools provide results fast and enable the team to adjust treatments promptly.
Since February, I've not been well. Headaches, fever, stomach aches. So I had a viral load test done. I'd been taking my medicine for a few years, so I didn't expect to have such a high viral load. I attended counselling for 3 months, then I was tested again. They said the viral load was reduced compared to my first test. I was very happy. After the first test, I'd lost hope.
This streamlining allows the teams to treat 35,000 patients in the district of Chiradzulu alone. Meanwhile, the Malawi Ministry of Health has implemented HIV programs in other regions. MSF, whose project has demonstrated its effectiveness, does not intend to take the place of the government. The teams are continuing to simplify and decentralize treatment in partnership with the Ministry of Health in order to eventually hand over its activities.